tell your mom too, baby. That's right. Don't tell our mom.
They were adamant. They're like, you haven't went down there yet? I'm like, no, I haven't got the opportunity. They're like, you need to go down there.
And I just had a talking head, and I should have used my earbuds for the fucking audio. I wasn't even thinking about it. Okay, now I'm doing it now, so I want to see how this sounds. But hey, it looked good. That's important, right? It's good to look good. All right. So while I got you here, Nick, tell me three things that you're looking forward to about this event. You said a couple of them. I'm going to do one to start you off. I just want to do one. And that is, all right, two bars, 500 people. Go.
So we have the ability to do two stages, which is really cool. That means we can fit more artists, right? More diversity of music, more artists, more opportunity. There's also a middle area, which I think would be amazing for vendors, food vendors, art vendors. So there's opportunity there.
Just talking to you, Joe. What'd you say, Joe? Our next food truck is gonna be what, at Dreamland?
There's already artwork here up on the walls, which is great. So they're already that style.
What's the lineup?
Well, like, there's a lineup that's
but tickets are being sold already, right?
Yeah, we just released them today.
That's what I like to hear. You know why? Because I like people who like to do business. Yes, buy your tickets before the lineup gets here.
I don't even know the lineup.
Are you on it?
Maybe. I don't know that either. I'm pretty sure I'm on like all of them because I'm a resident DJ. So is Philip. Philip's a resident DJ. Troy is a hip hop artist. Troy is also a part of the crew. Troy is a hip hop artist. So he's a part of the lineup. I know at least that.
These are some old school Tucson.
There are some old school Tucson people. They're a part of DDR, Dirty Desert Raver.
Nice.
So DDR Entertainment, that was Dirty Desert Raver. So they're kind of bringing that Dirty Desert style shit back.
We like to get dirty, baby.
Ask venue.
So I don't know if you noticed, I used to throw after hours parties.
That's what you were telling me.
I had two clubs. I had one at El Mariachi, was right off of Miracle Mile, and I had one on downtown on Congress, right across from where the diner used to be.
Yeah, right by my Ansel's shop. Right by Hydra.
I got shut down by the DEA at El Mariachi, and we never got shut down another one. But we were doing alcohol. I mean, we were completely illegal.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we didn't even try.
We didn't even try.
No, we were just pocketing fistfuls of cash.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes, like, you know, y'all are rowdy.
See, I was a young kid. I wouldn't do that these days. These days, I do it like Nick does it. That's why I like this guy. So, all right. I want to see you guys at the next one. Nick, thank you for the invitation. And we talked a little bit on the first round about WallingWorld and our 501c3.
Yes.
And so I'll just briefly cut to the point where, guys, we got a lot of people out there. It's fucking 112 degrees outside on an average summer day. And I'm taking
a collared shirt on.
I take about 3 to 4 guys a week out to go do marketing door to door. They need clothes, they need haircuts, they need all this type of shit. Mr. Walling is running out of moolah, and I can't continue to do that. So I want to do something here with that, and I just want your commitment that you might be able to help out with it.
You might be able to help out. I'm sure that there's some opportunity there. I don't see why not.
And
as
guys,
long as the venue's cool with it, as long as the team's cool with it, I don't see why we wouldn't be cool with it. I'm cool with it. Everyone go and take a look at From the Heart Productions. They're an awesome 501c3 nonprofit organization out of LA that sponsors filmmakers. So if you yourself are a filmmaker, or if you know a filmmaker, go check out From the Heart Productions, because they're awesome.